welcome to my review of Ghostbusters the Game. In Ghostbusters the Game, you play a new recruit to the Ghostbusters team, but you happen to join the team on the wrong night. A psychokinetic blast has released all kinds of ghosts and baddies from the first two films, and you have to go out with the Ghostbusters to take them down. I won't spoil too much of the story, but there's a lot of ghosts to take care of and a lot of memorable places from the films. The storyline is simply its strongest part of the game. It's extremely well written, it's very funny, it's very witty, and it's extremely well performed. It's just, I've never laughed this much during a video game in my entire life. It's a really funny game, and it's worth playing the game alone just for the storyline. The voiceovers in the game are spectacular. Almost all of the original Ghostbusters cast are in the game. The two exceptions are Rick Moranis and Sigourney Weaver. They are absent, however, this does not hurt the game. The game's storyline is simply immensely enjoyable, is the best way to put it. And the voiceovers are extremely well done. Everyone pulled their weight and gave an outstanding performance. You could tell that they all were really enjoying themselves and really wanted to be here. There's a lot of subtle in-jokes to the previous films, but even if you're not familiar with the other Ghostbusters films, there's still a lot of great humor here that a lot of people can enjoy. The graphics to the game, for the most part, are extremely well done. The textures look spectacular. The character animations look great, with the exception of when a character falls over, it doesn't look as natural as it should. But for the most part, all the character animations, the ghosts, the levitating, the objects moving look spectacular. The character designs are also immensely well done. All of the characters look exactly like they did in the films, and it's just a really nice quality to see that in the game. They paid great attention to detail in the game and made it look spectacular. The level design in the game is also one of its outstanding points. There's a lot of memorable locations that we saw in the films, and they're all in the game for the most part, and they're just spectacular. It's a lot of fun to play through Ghostbusters HQ, the hotel from the first Ghostbusters film, the Sedgwick, especially in the dining room battling Slimer. It's a lot of fun, and it really brings back great memories from the films, and it's also really funny. Whenever there's something cool happens on screen, the characters always said something funny to say about it. The special effects, like the proton packs and everything in the game, are extremely well animated, and it's really nice to see that they really paid, again, a lot of attention to detail. The gameplay is also really, really fun. It's really amazing to see a game based off of a film that is this fun. A lot of them are just lackluster cash-ins, and this is not a lackluster cash-in. They paid a lot of attention to how the ghost catching and the combat in the original Ghostbusters film was, and for the most part, it's replicated here almost perfectly. You'll zap the ghosts with a proton pack until they're subdued enough to capture them in the stream and then force them into the traps. It's a lot of fun, and the mechanics work really well, and I don't think I've seen anything like this in any other game. Also, you'll be battling some of the minions, gargoyles, mini marshmallows, and you'll just zap them until they explode with the proton pack, and that's a lot of fun. The combat itself is just really satisfying and really well designed, and again, it's something different. The only game I can really think of that's similar to this in its animation and possibly combat style, maybe Gears of War. The developers were calling it Gears of War Lite, so I guess that's why it feels sort of similar to Gears of War, although there's no cover system. There really wouldn't be any tagline. The boss battles in the game are a lot of fun, and while some of the bosses have somewhat cheap moves sometimes, the game never becomes over challenging. It's just right. The difficulty setting is perfect for the game. Overall, it's just a game that's a lot of fun to play. It's got a lot of fun puzzles, and it just really captures the Ghostbusters feeling. I didn't know exactly what to expect from the game, but as soon as the game started, I was pleasantly surprised by the voiceovers, the storyline, and the gameplay, and really just sat down, relaxed, and enjoyed a fantastic game. The game may be short-lasting, between 4 to 7 hours depending on difficulty, but there's a lot of reasons to replay the game. For example, you could go back and get all the collectibles, scan all the ghosts, or get as much money as you can to upgrade the Proton Pack as much as you want. But it's also great just to replay the storyline and just to see it all over again, because just like a great film, you're going to want to replay this one again. It's a game that's easily to recommend to Ghostbusters fans, and easy to recommend to non-Ghostbusters fans. If you don't like Ghostbusters to begin with, then this isn't the game for you. However, if you're open to Ghostbusters films and games, and you just want to play a game where you can slam some ghosts around and play something that's not your average third-person shooter, then I highly recommend this game. It's a rarity that a game, the movie, gets a 5 out of 5, but this is one of those rare occasions. The Ghostbusters, the video game, gets a 5 out of 5. It's an immensely fun and enjoyable game that I highly recommend. Thanks for watching my review of Ghostbusters, the game. Please rate, comment, and subscribe, and we'll see you in my next review.
It wasn't me this time, I swear it.